Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this episode, we are going to talk about a trick to create a 3D effect on website using CSS and transparent video background with no JavaScript at all. We are going to recreate the example you are seeing together in 5 minutes. Ready? Let's check it out. Normally, if we want to put a 3D model on website, then using 3JS is usually the way to go. However, 3JS requires some work with JavaScript and experience with the library. So alternative trick is we are going to render the 3D model into video format with transparent background and then embed it to the website. This is different from using GIF image as GIF doesn't support alpha channel, which means you can either have a fully transparent or opaque pixel. So effects like fading light, shadow, or smoke is out of question. Not to mention, GIF only works with low resolution and frame rate. So let's start the tutorial. First, we need a 3D model. If you haven't got one already, you can find a free model on Sketchfab website and import it to Blender. For this tutorial, I use a Blender add-on to import the model directly to the scene. Open the Sketchfab add-on from the menu and type the model you need and click import. Then make sure the model is in the view of the scene camera. Then press F12 to render. As you can see, it's too dark, so I will add some light to the scene. You can try experiment with light setup and press F12 to render. Okay, this looks good. Next, we will work on the animation rendering. We will need a couple settings in order to render a transparent video. First, go to the render properties and check transparent in film section. Next, go to the output setting and select FFmpeg video file format. Then select WebM container and WebM video codec. And then select RGBA color to enable alpha channel. And that's all we need. You can start the animation render from the menu or press Ctrl F12. Note that you can change the number of the end frame to control the video length. We'll also need to render the video in MOV format to support Safari. Change both container and codec to QuickTime and render again. Now you should have two videos as the result. Copy them to your website directory. In HTML, we'll just use the video tag with autoplay, mute, loop, and place in line option. And link to the video source of both files. And that's it. Looks good. Now I'm going to combine this example with CSS neon text effect from my previous tutorial. So let's add a text div. And then I will copy CSS from previous example. You can find a link to the code at the description box below. Next, I will set the position to absolute. and place it 30% from top. Then set the z-index so that the video is in front of the neon text. Then add some keyframe to dim out the light and create a flickering effect. And that's all for this tutorial. Don't forget to like or subscribe if you love this video. Thanks for watching. See you next update. Bye.